Not long ago, we posted the teardown of HAGiBiS 65W GaN charger with an HDMI board, so you can activate TV mode without charging dock. Today we got another similar desktop charger from Baseus, which also comes with an HDMI port. So today let's go ahead and take apart this Baseus 67W GaN5 desktop charger. Baseus logo, 67W, and product name are printed on the front. Flip to the back, the detailed specs info are on the back. Tear off the sealing strip on the top and open the box. It contains some cotton stickers, documents, the desktop charger and power cord. This is a dual USB-C cable wrapped with a cable tie. The cable length is about 1.1 meters. The charger LED power ZKM002C shows is equipped with an eMarker chip. The maximum power can be up to 100 watts, and the USB 4 cable can provide up to 40 gigabits per second. Take it out from the plastic film. It adopts a rectangular design with a non-detachable power cord. The cord is pretty thick and its junction is protected by sleeve to improve its durability. It adopts a black matte shell with round edges, and the Baseus logo is in the middle. The specs info are printed on the button. Model is CCGAN67-HDS. It can support input of 110 to 240 volts, 50 or 60Hz, 1.5 amp. Both USB-C ports can support up to 65 watts output power. The HDMI port can support up to 4K 30Hz. It also passed ETL and FCC certifications. Except for the two USB-C ports we just mentioned, there are USB-A and an HDMI port on the output panel, and an LED indicator light is on the top of the panel. Here is the input 2-prong block, which has qualified to Intertech. The power cord length is about 1.5 meters. The size of this desktop charger is about 96.5 by 46 by 38 mm. And the weight is about 315 grams. Connected to the charger LED power ZKM002C, it shows the USB-C one supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, PD 3.0, PBS, QC5, Samsung 5V 2A protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.35A, and a set of PBS. Switching to USB-C 2, we can see it only supports PD 3.0 protocol, and the fixed PDOs info are exactly the same as USB-C 1. As for the USB-A port, it doesn't support any fast charging protocol. Next, let's start from the AC input end to remove the back cover. Use the spudger to pry along the gap and remove it. Now we can easily take out the internal module. The entire PCBA module consists of three different PCBs and is filled with blue silicon adhesives to enhance heat dissipation. The input wire is connected to the PCBA and the junction is reinforced with white silicon adhesives. The time delay fuse, EMI filter circuit, transformer, solid capacitor, and buck inductors are on the front. Flip to the back, we can see the bridge rectifier, mass controller, GaNFET, synchronous rectifier, and secondary buck circuit are on the back. Charger LED found it adopts QR flyback topology with two independent synchronous buck circuits for output. Those two bridge rectifiers can form a half bridge circuit used to dissipate the heat evenly. And this is the QR flyback PWM master controller, optimized for PD fast charging. The GaNFET is next to the master controller, suitable for QR flyback and LDLC topology. Those two buck chips are on the top and used for buck control and protocol identification. And this is an MCU, which is used to detect the internal temperature and control the power. The transformer is on the front. Moving on to the video conversion PCB, this is the DP to HDMI converter IC, and the HDMI port is in here. Those two chips are used for synchronous step down. Flip to the back, two VBUS MOSFETs for power supply control are connected in series. This is the third small PCB with a USB-C and a USB-A port. It connects to the video conversion PCB through the wire on the top. Well, that's a brief teardown of this Baseus 67W GaN5 desktop charger. After taking apart, we found the internal module could be divided into three different parts. The video conversion and switching power supply are on two independent PCBs. So when you are charging, you can connect your handheld game console like Steam Deck and Switch to a larger display without a charging dock. Okay, that's all for today's video. Feel free to click the corners to check the teardown of other desktop chargers. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!